You're listening to the Monday Night Community Show with Daniel on BRFM.
This is the Daniel Monday Night Community Show on demand through YouTube. Thank you very much for choosing to listen to us through this method. If you'd like to keep up to date with when I add new interviews, then subscribe to this channel. So we're next going to be talking to Paul, and Paul is from the BTO. Firstly, thank you very much for talking to us.
Hello. Yes, I've been working at the British Trust for Ornithology for 8 years now, and I work in the communications department as the media manager. But that also means that I, you know, not solely working on just media, I get involved in all sorts of projects with the Trust as well. So it's quite a varied role.
So, okay. Paul, I was hoping you could next tell me in general and tell our listeners a little bit about the BTO, please.
Well, here at the BTO, we're a scientific research organisation, and we monitor the populations of birds across Britain and Ireland and produce trends on an annual basis. So we're constantly looking at whether birds are going up and down. And we have a staff of around 110 individuals. Most of them are scientists who hold a PhD. And not only do they help produce the trends, but they also look into causes behind the trends, you know, why a species might be declining and why a species might be increasing.
So what would sort of be the typical day for the kind of people working there? Could you tell us a bit more in detail about that?
Well, it varies across the organisation. My day may involve me talking to a journalist. As of this morning, for instance, on a phone call, I was talking about the impact that drugs might have on wildlife in the environment. And then I'm also producing press releases around an awards ceremony that we'll be holding in a few weeks' time. And then talking to scientists about the work that they're doing. And for our scientists, some of those will be producing a long-term trend. For instance, we've run a heronry survey now since 1929. And they'll be looking at the data that's coming this year as we're coming towards the end of the year and starting to produce and update that trend.
Was there anything locally to us in Kent you'd like to cover for our listeners?
Well, I think Kent's a really interesting county. We're seeing at the moment, again, you know, looking at all the work that our volunteers do. I mean, this is the lifeblood of the BTO, our volunteers going out there collecting data, submitting it to the scientists here so that the numbers can be crunched and those trends produced. And what we're seeing for Kent is really, really interesting. We're seeing that there's a general shift of some species from the southeast to the north and west. And we think it's probably because Kent is becoming a drier, cooler county, and the north and west is becoming kind of milder and wetter. And, you know, just certainly for species that spend the whole winter in the UK, those conditions are much, much better.
Was there anything else you'd like to get over to our listeners?
Well, the British Trust for Ornithology is quite a grand name, but, you know, we have surveys for everybody. So anybody can get involved in the work of the BTO. From doing Garden Birdwatch, we have our Garden Birdwatch survey runs right throughout the year, every single week of the year. And we ask people to submit records of the birds that they see in their gardens. And again, we can see how garden birds are doing over the course of a year. And that's been running since 1995. We have other surveys where there's a little bit more specialism needed, a little bit more experience, like the Breeding Bird Survey or the Wetland Bird Survey. And these are carried out using standardised recording methods. But again, anybody with a knowledge of birds can do them. You don't have to be a member of the BTO. And then if you go out on a walk and you see birds, you can submit them to the bird track survey. And that can be every single bird you see on your walk or just one sighting if you want to. And all that information will get put into the huge database that the BTO hold.
So if our listeners would like to find out a little bit more about that, how could they do that?
Well, the first port of call would be the BTO website at bto.org, and if they were to look under the Volunteer Surveys tab, they can look at the surveys that may suit them. But also there's a Regional Network tab, and under that tab there will be contact details for the regional representative for Kent.
Well, Paul, I'd like to thank you very much, giving our listeners a bit of an introduction into what you do and telling them all about the BTO as well. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.